Hello guys, I'm Bhavna Chawla. Welcome to Smart Horizon. In this video, we will learn about the color panels. In the previous videos, we have learned how to create our own workspace. So this is my workspace named My Panel. We will open a new document. If you do not have the swatches panel here, you can always go to Windows, scroll down to swatches. To select a color, we pick a color from the swatches panel. As you can see, when we hover to a color, our cursor changes to a dropper-like icon. To select a color, we will click on a color. When we click on a color, you can see here our foreground color changes. To change our background color, we first toggle between the colors by pressing X. As you can see here, I am toggling the colors, or I can simply press this arrow key to toggle between the colors, and then I can select another color that I want. These are the colors that I want as my foreground and my background color. We can always pick a color from an image. Like here is the image. If I want this green color to get selected, what I'll do is I'll activate eyedropper tool. This is our eyedropper tool, or I can simply press I. I is the short key of eyedropper tool, and I will click on the color that I want to get selected. As you can see, my foreground color changes here. The color in the top of the swatches panel, these are the colors I am talking about, are the colors we have used recently. To directly change the foreground color, we will click on this foreground color icon. Here is a full color spectrum. We will select a color that I want, like I want blue, and then I'll select or click on the shade of blue that I want. And I'll press OK. This will change our foreground color. The same we can do with the background color. We can even add a color to the swatches panel. For that, I'll click on the foreground color icon. I'll select a color and I'll click on add to swatches. I'll give it a name, my new color, and I'll press OK. Here we can see this color is added to the swatches panel. If we hover it, we can see the name, my new color, that I have given it. Now we will open a new file. Here is an image. Here in this file, we will see these small boxes in the background, this gray and white one. This is nothing but a transparent background. If we try to move this shape, we can see only the shape is moving, not the background. This shows that the background is transparent here. So this is it for this session. Thank you for watching. If you like the video, kindly press the like button and subscribe to my channel. Don't forget to press the bell icon to get notified when we upload new content. Thank you.